Welcome once again, dear students, in our YouTube channel technofun.kvs. In our earlier videos of recap of Python of class 7th, we have discussed about the introduction of Python and its features and advantages. We have also discussed about the algorithm and the flowchart. Now in this video, we are going to discuss about the variable data types and keywords. So, which are the basic tokens in any programming language? So what is a variable and why we have to use it? A variable is an identifier or a simple name used for a value which is used in during the program time. For example, if we have to accept the marks or declare some marks, suppose 75.8, so we will declare a variable. A variable means the name of the memory location in which we store some temporary values for the program time. As and when we need various values for the program, so that is why we declare variables and give our user-friendly names. Like if we are going to make a particular program in which we have to accept two sides of a rectangle, then we have to create two variables named L or B. These names or the variables are used to store some length and breadth of a particular rectangle object. So we need variables for this. The second thing, as you can see on the screen, data type. Data type is also the same here as we have discussed in our DBMS, database concepts. Data type specifies that what kind of data we have to store in our variables. As we know that, that data types specifies that what kind of data, what type of data are or should be stored in a particular variable. As we have the programs, we make softwares for our problems. That is why we have to already ensure this, that what kind of values, what kind of data types we have to select for our variables. So if we want to store some decimal values, then we will give the flow data type. If we want to store the name of a person or a student, then we will use the string data type. If we want to enter some simple numeric values, then we will use the integers. So in order to store a particular type of value, we need its data type. The given table will show some of the common data types as used in Python. You can see here, we have some sample values, like we have the integer values. The data type should be treated as int. For decimal values, float. For character type values, like alphabets, we have alphanumeric characters. We will use the string. Special characters and symbols also comes in the string. So data types are some building blocks of any programming language like we have in the Python. The next important point is our keyword. Keyword is what? Keyword is a predefined reserved name in any programming language which has some fixed working or function. Its working function cannot be changed at all during programming. Some of the examples are if, else, in, for, which we will learn in our Python language in the coming days. So keyword is a reserved name, and it is very, very important to be remembered that what is the function of which keyword, because it will work, it will help to easily make our softwares. Now next is also, as you can see, a very important topic here, the operators. Operators, we are discussing two types of operators, arithmetic and relational. First of all, we need to understand what we mean by an operator. Operators are some special alphanumeric symbols which are used to perform operation on some operands. Like we are adding two values, suppose 2 plus 5. Here plus is an operator and working on the operands 2 and 5. So like we have the multiply, divide and various arithmetic operators. Now, what is an expression? As you can see here in the example, we are writing here x equal to 5 plus 6. Here plus is a operator, 5 and 6 are the operands, and x equal to 5 plus 6 is complete. This complete statement is called an expression which will have the combination of various operator and operands. So expression will give some kind of output. Okay. Now what are arithmetic operators? This is a type of operator which we will discuss here. We have addition, subtraction, multiplication, division and modulus. This modulus operator is very important. It will give the remainder of two numbers when we divide. Means As you can see in the example, we are dividing 5 by 2 and we are using modulus 5 modulus 2. This will give actually the remainder. This will store 1 in the variable x. Like we have the floor division, in the division, third type of division, divides and truncates the fractional part from result. X equal to 7, floor division 2 will give 3. 3 means the answer will come here 3.5. But this particular floor division operator discards the decimal part or the floating part and gives only the 3 value. The next operator, arithmetic operator, is of exponential operator. Exponent means when we create a to the power b or x to the power y, then we say we are using exponential operators. Like we have x equal to 3, exponential operator 3, 2 stars, then it will give you the result 27. So this is all about the arithmetic operators. I hope you will enjoy this. Now, next point, next topic is our relational operator. As we have the arithmetic operators, like we have very important relational operator. Relational operator, as you can see on your screen in the table, we have the greater than, less than, greater than equals to, less than equal to. And when we use two equals to, then we will actually comparing two values, whether A is equal to B or not. If we are using, this is the quality of relational operator, that it will give one value from true and false, means either a particular condition is true or either a particular condition is false. So every relational operator will give you one of these two values, either true, either false. When we use exclamation not equal to, then it is treated to be as a not equals to sign. A not equals to B. As we can see in the example, the value of A is 9 and the value of B is 5. So if we use A not equals to B, that means this condition is true. The result will come here true. I think you have enjoyed these relational operators, as we will use these relational operators in our programming very much. Thank you for watching this video.